Batman, Batman, Batman. Heard that you ain't got a mattress. Heard that you king of Manhattan. Welcome everyone to a new video. So today we're going to be talking about, should Christians listen to secular rap? Now I know this can be a bit of a controversial topic among Christian rappers and just Christians in general, and I guess it's different with rap because it's uniquely profane in nature, and a lot of it I guess is contradictory to what Christians believe. I guess there is a bit of divide. So I was watching The Cruise later this video, and they expressed their views on listening to secular rappers, and I saw some of the comments. Quite a few of them were pretty negative, and I thought it would be good to share my thoughts on it and create a discussion around it. So after this video, once I've shared my thoughts on it, you can start a conversation in the comments. So, and also I've seen people talking about it on Twitter and stuff as well. So I never used to listen to rap at all because of how profane it is. I guess I always liked the sound of rap, but I just never really listened to mainstream because, you know, I thought it was, I just never listened to it. And then I found out about Christian rap, and then I kind of got into it. I started listening to all the Reach guys, and then kind of through that I got into the wider rap scene, started getting into some of the other artists as well. But yeah, for a while there I got sucked into it. I listened to quite a bit of it, and now I guess I don't really listen to mainstream or secular rap recreationally. And I do listen to some mainstream rap, mostly to see what are the upcoming artists, what are the trends. I guess it's kind of to do with my videos as well. I guess for me is that usually you surround yourself with, like, if you want to relax or listen to music, you listen to something that you can relax to and that I guess you agree with as well, because if you don't agree with it, then you're going to be shielding yourself from, I mean, that's what it feels like when I'm listening to secular rap. I always have to shield myself from whatever they're saying, or I guess it can be with anything, but with secular rap it can be a bit worse than most other genres of music or anything in life, I guess. And so usually recreationally I pretty much only listen to Christian rap, or I guess lately I've been on a bit of a almost like an ambient kind of sounding background music, like kind of like the background music I had on the John Gibbs video. But that's pretty much all I listen to now recreationally. And you know, I have, occasionally I do get hooked on mainstream or secular songs. I guess they're not really mainstream, but mainstream rap or secular rap. I'm not perfect. Like I get hooked on some songs sometimes, but it always feels wrong when I do it, even though I find the song really catchy. For example, lately, Jaden Smith's Batman, that is, like, the feel of it's really nice, and the beat's really nice, and the flow's nice, but I know what he's talking about. It's like contrary to what you believe. Same with like Lil Uzi's EXO Tour Life. I kind of got hooked on that song as well, but it's always felt like wrong or I guess sinful to me. And when I see all these Christians or Christian rappers talking in comments or on Twitter or whatever, most of the Americans are on Twitter, talking about these rappers and like how much they like them, and they feel so comfortable. I just don't get it. Like, how can you be so comfortable? I'm not trying to condemn anyone here, these are just my thoughts. I don't get how you can be so comfortable around people's music that directly contradicts what your mission statement is. I mean, that's more directed at the Christian rappers, but yeah, I mean, I get how you could like the production of a song, the way it sounds, the flow, maybe the person's lyrical ability as well, but it's just some people I think feel way too comfortable in the Christian community with these rappers. And I guess, yeah, it just seems a bit contradictory, especially of your mission, which I mean, most Christian rappers, their mission should be to, I guess, spread the gospel or spread the message in some sort of way. I mean, it doesn't mean you can't have fun songs, but you know, that's the general rule, I guess, for any Christian anyway. And I'm fascinated by it in a way as well, because yeah man, it's interesting. Like, sometimes it almost makes you question their faith in a way, but kind of like you surround yourself with people that can uplift you. I think of music in the same way as well. I know depending on what songs I've been listening to, I'll sit down in bed or lie down in bed and I'll just have that song ringing over and over in my head. And if that's a bad song, that can actually be kind of bad, I guess. So let me know your thoughts. This is where I hand it over to you. I know not everyone agrees with me, so start a discussion in the comments. Let me know your thoughts. I'll be replying, joining in with the discussion as well. Thank you guys so much for 1500 subs. Let's keep this growing. Let's keep growing Christian hip hop together. And I guess over the last few months, that's kind of been my goal. I know my earlier stuff wasn't as uplifting, but I think that's been my goal over the last, I guess, 2 months specifically, to kind of uplift Christian hip hop, make positive content that will help grow Christian hip hop as well. And I appreciate your guys' support, and I really like the, I guess, the community that we have in the comments as well. So thank you guys for watching. Let me know your thoughts. Leave a like on this video if you enjoyed. Subscribe if you want to see more. And I'll see you guys in my next video.